Dano, get your coat. Where to?
According to the governor, to head off World War III.
I'm Gerard Gifford. The governor called and said you're on your way.
McGarrett, Dan Williams.
How do you do, Mr. Williams?
Mr. Gifford.
Joseph Soffer, Mr. Rostov's secretary. He's talking to the Soviet embassy in Washington. The car is mine, put at Mr. Rostov's disposal. This is unimportant to me, but you will recover it, won't you?
We try, Mr. Gifford, we try. But cars stolen on this island are stolen for one reason. Thieves can't get very far with them, so they steal them to strip them.
I just cannot understand how a senseless thing like this could happen.
Mr. McGarrett, if you're certain it was the car and not the Grenarius the thief was after, I have a suggestion to make. That we make a public appeal for the return of the violin. I'm prepared to offer a substantial reward, no questions asked, if the violin is returned.
No, absolutely not.
Why not, Mr. McGarrett? I'm Joseph Sapa. Just made a similar suggestion to our embassy in Washington. Why are you opposed?
Because there's a possibility that whoever stole Mr. Gifford's car may not know the violin is in the trunk. Therefore, they don't know the value.
But if they strip the car, won't they look in the trunk?
Spare tire is one of the main things they go for.
True. But if they don't know the value of it, they may leave it, figuring it isn't worthwhile bothering with.
But if the thief knows, he'll receive a reward.
Mr. Rostov, if you make a public appeal, and they find out that you have a priceless Guarnerius, I don't know what your chances are of ever getting your violin back. Now, I ask you, please, give me your assurance that you'll keep this quiet.
I'm afraid such an assurance can come only our embassy in Washington. And now, if you'll excuse us, Mr. Rostov and I will return to our hotel.
One moment, Sarpa. My Guarnerius is one of only a very few left in the world. I call it mine, but I do not think of it as such. In a sense, it belongs to everyone who loves music. It would be their loss as well. Find it, Mr. McGarrett. Bring it back. That is all that matters.
You convince your embassy of that, Mr. Rostov.
It wasn't the violin that was stolen, Governor. It was Mr. Gifford's car.
The State Department tells me that distinction won't satisfy the Russians, who obviously see an excuse to embarrass this country in the eyes of the world. Washington's even worried that Moscow may use this incident as an excuse to cancel a cultural exchange program.
Governor, VIVO is doing all it can. So is HPD. We've got choppers in the air. We've got checkpoints all over town. Identification is pulling files on anyone, whoever stole a wheel cover. But there's one thing that we both have to face, and face now.
What's that?
An ignition jumper was used on that car. That means somebody knew what they were doing. Now, that car could be stripped down, being sold piece by piece, right now, all over Oahu.
And the violin?
Your guess is as good as mine.